Okay guys, so this is the fourth video. Let's have a quick review regarding the equations. So as you can see, the total fixed costs, they do not change. So they are always constant. It's the same number given. Total variable costs, usually it would be given and you multiply it by the number of units. And then we have total cost is both fixed and variable, and these are the averages. Now, mainly in your book, what you are responsible for is the average total cost. And as we said before, we care about it being at its minimum. Okay, and so here we have average cost, and here we have quantity, and this is the optimum point. Now we will solve another exercise to make it absolutely clear for you guys. All right, so right now let's solve this exercise together. We need to answer the questions. The first one is complete the chart. As we know, fixed cost, they didn't give me anything, but I can find it. I have the total cost given. And as I know, the total cost is fixed cost plus variable cost. So 0 plus what will give me 30? This would be 30. If it's 30 for 0 units, no matter what, remember, it should be 30 for all of the quantity of masks produced, no matter what the quantity is. So very easy for this one. I will start putting 30, 30, 30, 30. Total cost, I will just need to add. So they gave me the first one. What I will be doing for the second one, 10 plus 30, 40, 25 plus 30, 55, 75, 100, 130, and 165. Okay, average variable cost, I do variable cost divided by the quantity. So I need to look at this, the variable cost and the quantity. 0 divided by 0, impossible. 10 divided by 1, 10. 25 divided by 2, 12.5, and so on. Okay, so this would be 15, 17.5, 20, and 22.5. Average fixed cost, it would be 6 cost divided by quantity. So I need to look at this column and this column. 30 divided by 0, impossible. 30 divided by 1, 30. 30 divided by 2, 15. And so on. 10, 7.5, 6, and 5. Now I need to find the average total cost, and this is what I care about as an owner or an entrepreneur of a company. So I need to do total cost divided by quantity. So I need to look at that column and I divide it by that column. Also, 30 divided by 0, it is impossible. 40 divided by 1, 40. 55 divided by 2, 27.5. This is 25, this is 25, this is 26, and this is 27.5. Again, as you can see, it's decreasing, reached the minimum, and then it started increasing again. So let me answer the questions. Number one, complete the chart. I am done. What is the fixed cost for the mask manufacturing firm? As you can see, no matter what the unit of production, it is always 30 in this example. So $30. Explain what happens to variable cost as more labor is hired. If I'm paying them a wage, I need to pay for them per hour. So definitely the more labor I hire, the more my variable cost would be. Okay, Question number, what's it called? Four. At what rate of production is average total cost at a minimum? It's at unit three and unit four. So here. And why is it important for a company to know what its average total cost per item is? Because as a firm, my major aim is always to minimize my cost or maximize my profits. So right here, I know it would be better for me to produce a 3 or 4 units of mask in thousands, okay? So 3,000 or 4,000. So it wouldn't be good for me to produce nothing, because no matter what, there will be an a fixed cost that I need to pay. I need to pay the rent, I need to pay the loan installments, and so on. And at 5,000 and 6,000, my average total cost started to increase again. So it would have been better to produce less. So in general, therefore, the average cost of each unit of a good or a service will tend to fall with the volume produced, simply because fixed costs remain the same, but their burden is spread over a much larger output. However, after a point, average costs may start to rise again, as you can see in units 5,000 and 6,000, because it can become more difficult and expensive to increase output further. Okay, that would be it for today. Please make sure you are writing your notes on your copybook neatly. I want you to send an image. And do not forget, since I explained all types of costs and profits and losses and break even, please, I would like you to try and solve exercise bare necessities, the cost of bare necessities on page 232. And next week we will be solving it together again, but I need to see your answers. Thank you. Have a lovely day.